The God you save may be yourself. All religions of spiritual nature are inventions of man. He has created an entire system of gods with nothing more than his carnal brain. Just because he has an ego and cannot accept it, he has had to externalize it into some great spiritual device, which he calls God. God can do all things man is forbidden to do, such as kill, perform miracles to gratify his will, control without any apparent responsibility, etc. If man needs a God and recognizes that God, then he is worshiping an entity that the human being invented. Therefore, he is worshiping by proxy the man that invented God. That God. No, the man that invented God. Is it not more sensible to worship a God that he himself has created in accordance with his own emotional needs, one that best represents his very carnal and physical being, and that has the ideal power, the idea power to invent a God in the first place? If a man insists on externalizing his true self in the form of God, then why fear his true self in fearing God? Why praise his true self, God? Why remain externalized from God in order to engage in ritual and religious ceremony in his name? Man needs ritual and dogma, but no law states that an externalized God is necessary in order to engage in ritual and ceremony performed in a God's name. Could it be when he closes the gap between himself and his God, he sees the demon of pride creeping forth, that very embodiment of Lucifer appearing in his midst? He no longer can view himself in two parts, the carnal and the spiritual, but sees them merge into one. And then, to the abysmal horror, he discovers that there is only the carnal, and always were. Then he either hates himself to death day by day, or rejoices that he is what he is. If he hates himself, he searches out a new and more complex spiritual paths of enlightenment and hopes that he may split himself up again in this quest for stronger and more externalized gods to scourge his poor miserable shell. If he accepts himself, but recognizes that ritual and ceremony are important devices that his invented religion have utilized to sustain his faith as a lie, then in the same form of ritual that will sustain his faith in truth, the primitive pageantry that will give his awareness of his own majestic being added substance. When all religious faith in lies has waned, it is because man has become closer to himself and farther from God. Closer to the devil. If this is what the devil represents, and man lives his life in the devil's fane, with the sinews of Satan moving his flesh, then he either escapes from the cracklings and crappings of the righteous, or stands proudly in his secret places on earth and manipulates the folly-ridden masses through his own satanic might, until that day he may come forth in splendor proclaiming, "I am a Satanist. Bow down, for I am the highest embodiment of human life. I am a Satanist. Bow down, for I am the highest embodiment of human life."